Hi guys, thank you for joining me. I'm working on my third cup of coffee today, but I want to cover these earthquakes that have been happening off the coast of Oregon. Yesterday, there was a magnitude 3.1. These are what's called intraplate earthquakes, earthquakes that are not located along any plate boundary, along ancient fault lines that have now been reactivated. We got a 3.1. The other day there was a 3.4. That was on the 21st. And then, let's see here. On the 30th of May, there was a magnitude 3.2. We're going to see an increase of what they call intraplate earthquakes. I just posted a video about the intraplate earthquakes that have been happening there. Along the Sandwich Islands. That's down there below South America. There has been a few intraplate earthquakes that have been devastating. The most significant that people probably would remember was the 1811-1812 New Madrid earthquake. And then of late, we've been having a lot of them along the east coast of the United States. I'll give you a link to this paper on Wikipedia. The term of intraplate earthquakes refers to a variety of earthquakes that occur within the interior of a tectonic plate. This stands in contrast to interplate earthquakes, which occur at the boundary of tectonic plates. Intraplate earthquakes are relatively rare compared to the more familiar boundary-located interplate earthquakes. Structures far from plate boundaries tend to lack seismic retrofitting. You know, often there is no rebar, stone, lath and plaster. Yeah, they're very susceptible to earthquakes, buildings of that type. So, intraplate earthquakes can inflict heavy damage. They give, for example, of intraplate earthquakes, such as the Durat earthquake in 2001, the Indian Ocean earthquake in 2012. I believe about 15,000 people died from that one. The 2017 Puebla earthquake, and of course the New Madrid earthquake, 1811-1812. They have an image of these intraplate earthquakes here along the New Madrid fault zone. And many of you know already that this is an area of a failed rift system that goes up and around Lake Michigan. You should be aware of that if you follow me. There's other failed rift systems, meaning it's a rift where the country was going to divide in half, but it stopped. And there's been cases of other failed rift systems reactivating of late. Using Google Earth, here you can see all the earthquakes that are within the intraquake zone. We got the New Madrid. We got them in Tennessee, North Carolina, Maryland, Massachusetts, New Hampshire, etc. That is just within the last 30 days. There was one, I'm going to do a report about it because this one's real interesting, down here by South Carolina. That was a magnitude 1.8. That happened yesterday also. Those that follow prophecy should not be one bit of surprise when it talks about earthquakes in diverse places. Yeah, they don't have a focal mechanism ball for this 3.1. Four people said they did feel it. If these swarms of intraplate earthquakes continue, eventually they're going to have a very large one that could be devastating. Any of these earthquakes here off the coast of Oregon very well could trigger a major earthquake along the Cascadia subduction zone. Here we got reports from Bend and Roseburg. They said they felt that earthquake. So are you prepared for a major disaster? Do you have a bug out kit? Do you have a plan to get to higher ground in case of a tsunami? You know you will have to take into account for your evacuation plan. Debris in the roads, backed up, plugged traffic. And what about those with disabilities? Do you even have pet carriers for your pets in case you have to go to a place to be housed after an earthquake? So if you felt any of these earthquakes recently off the coast of Oregon, please put those comments down below. Thank you for watching. Thank you for subscribing. Thank you very much for your support. Please stay safe, and I will talk to you later. God bless you.